beautiful Cameret in the north of St. Lucia. It's a wonderful ambience where our master guides, for the first time in about 12 years, are camping in nature. And the main objective for this camp is to ensure that master guides are fully equipped and skilled in their natural habitat, learning survival skills, and of course, showing a knowledge of what they have been doing as part of their curriculum work. Tomorrow we'll be doing track and trail hike, furniture building, fire lighting with wet wood, and so on. So it's a lot of skills that we'll be displaying, and we'll be doing quite a lot, and the master guide is very, very excited. Past many years we've been camping in schools, and this is not the ideal. So we're very happy that after 12 years thereabout, we have brought camping back to the wilderness, to the nature, fulfilling the main objective of what master guiding is supposed to be. We were trying to keep this a secret because since we're in the open, the place is not fenced, security and the protection of master guides is of paramount importance. And so we really did not want people to know, so that a crowd can be here who are not registered master guides and registered for the camp. So we kept it a secret to ensure that we don't have the useless, unnecessary crowd, and to make this camp a hazard, or where the security of our master guides would be compromised. So this is why we really kept it a secret.
Yeah. say, welcome to the house of the Lord. But I say to you, welcome to the hills of the Lord.
Amen.
If you are going track and trail and climbing up a mountain, I would say to you, the God of the mountain is still God in the valley.
Right.
And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. If you are doing fancy drill, I would invite you to march with us this morning. And I would welcome you by saying, we are marching in the light of God. Marching to Zion, the beautiful city of God. If you were engaged in knot tying this morning, I would probably tie you a rescue bowline and say that Jesus is waiting for you and has thrown out a lifeline
to
those who feel helpless and need to be rescued.
Amen.
All you need to do is just trust him and grab hold of this line.
Amen.
If you were hiking, I would say to you, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for God is with us.
Alright.
If you were going to come cookery, I would tell you, oh, test and see that the Lord is good.
That is it.
But this morning, we are not doing knot tying, we are not drilling, we are not cooking, we are not
hiking,
we are camping, and not just camping, we are doing wilderness camping. So I say to you, so I want to welcome you by saying, the Lord thy God walketh in the midst of thy camp to deliver thee and to give up thine enemies before thee. Therefore shall thy camp be holy. So I say to you, the cattle upon a thousand hills are his. And I invite you to sit at the feet of our master guide, Jesus Christ, and let him be the compass of our life as he leads us through the paths of life.
Amen. Amen.
Don't try to hide your earthly stars. In his eyes, we all are equal. Yes, we are. Don't be afraid, come as you are.
At the table of grace, the cup's never empty, the place always full. And it's never too late, so come and be filled with love never ending. You're always welcome at the table of grace, at the table of grace. The cup's never empty, the place always full. And it's never too late, so come and love never ending. You're always welcome at the table of grace.
Anytime I hear this song, it reminds me of my home. Because I am from Grace.
Okay.
And every time they say the table of grace, I tend to look for that large table at my home. Where I can invite every Seventh-day Adventist. But I pray the Lord one day he's going to bless me. Where I can say to all Seventh-day Adventists, let's go to the table of grace in Grace. Amen? And where we're all going to be blessed. But this morning, we come here for another purpose. We come here for us to really recommit ourselves to God. And in Luke chapter 18, verse 1, the Bible tells us that men ought to pray and not to faint. In other words, we need to spend more time praying and giving our hearts totally to God. Communicating with him and giving him he's going to give us that assurance that when we pray, he's going to answer us. So this morning, we're going to sing the song, and my sister here will assist me in singing 309, All to Jesus, I Surrender. Because the first thing you need to do is to surrender yourself to God before you can ask God to deliver somebody else. So we're going to take some time, we're going to sing this song, and you're going to pray individually. You may have a little secret that you do not want your neighbor to know. I know we have certain restrictions, but you can find a little corner, a little place, and just talk to God personally this morning. Tell him what is bothering. Tell him what are some of your challenges. What is it that is aching? What is it that is paining you? And just bring it to the Lord in prayer. And just surrender it all to him. And afterwards, when we pray again, we will be praying for each other after we have totally surrendered our lives to Jesus Christ. This morning, we are going to do something different. You need to meet with someone who is not from your district. You are going to get to know that individual, get to know that person's name, any information that they would want to share with you. If they want to and share a testimony with this individual, and afterwards you're going to pray for each other.
To cover me.